Thousands of Zimbabweans have been celebrating the military takeover on the streets of Harare and calling for President Robert Mugabe to step down. Members of the ruling ZANU-PF party joined the protesters earlier, where they tried marching toward Mugabe's residence. Army chiefs are set to meet Mugabe on Sunday in a bid to end the crisis. Well, for more insight, I'm joined by Gervase Olagokenaka. He is a political analyst on Africa from the Lincoln University in Pennsylvania. Thank you so much for joining us. Let's start with the African Union. What has its response been so far?
Thanks again for the opportunity. The African Union president, the President of Guinea, issued a statement in which he was condemning the coup d'etat in Zimbabwe. But we know that the army said that it is not a coup d'etat, even though it is a takeover. So, you know, this is a situation that is not too clear.
I mean, there's been jubilation on the streets, but where does Zimbabwe go from here politically, particularly if the African Union is condemning a coup d'etat?
Yes, this is it's like a tradition that we've been witnessing in Africa for the last, decade. Anytime there is an army takeover in any African country, the immediate response or the expected response from the African Union is to condemn, you know, the coup d'etat. But in the case of Zimbabwe, it's a particular situation. Even though we respect Mugabe's fight, you know, for the independence of Zimbabwe, and even though we respect his defiance against neocolonialism. But I think that he is 93. I think he's tired, that it is time for him, you know, to step aside. And the army, and we have to know, in a country in crisis like Zimbabwe, the army can be or is the only institution that can restore law and order. And this is what the army is doing, and hoping that, you know, they understand, you know, the aspiration of the people, and they put into place like a framework according to which the people of Zimbabwe can negotiate a better future beyond, you know, the sweet and sour legacy of Robert Mugabe.
You must know the history of this continent better than most. How easy or difficult will it be to bring about democracy to Zimbabwe, considering it's been under Mugabe for almost four decades?
Yeah, Mugabe was a great leader, but at the same time, we cannot say that it was dictatorship, because there is multi-party system in Zimbabwe. He was certainly using every power he could use in order to maintain his power. But I think that today we saw that there are even people close to him, even the army. The people who did the army takeover are people close to him. So they understand that the time has come for them to think about the future of Zimbabwe beyond Mugabe. And then we will see how they negotiate, you know, that turning point or that negotiate, you know, the future of Zimbabwe. It's a possibility. And Africa is on the right track. And we can see, like, in Burkina Faso, in Benin, in Senegal, in different parts of Africa, we can see how the people are negotiating, expressing the desire, you know, to see more freedom and then to negotiate a better future. So I am hopeful for Zimbabwe.
Thank you so much for that insight. That's Gervase Olagokenaka, live from Pennsylvania.